हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, लेट अस स्टार्ट द नेक्स्ट चैप्टर, चैप्टर टू, होल नंबर्स. नाउ स्पीकिंग ऑफ नंबर्स, वी ऑल नो दैट व्हेन वी स्टार्टेड काउंटिंग वी यूज द नंबर्स 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 एंड सो ऑन. सो दीज आर द नंबर्स वी यूज्ड व्हेन वी स्टार्टेड काउंटिंग, व्हेन वी बिगिन टू काउंट. सो दे कम नेचुरली व्हेन वी स्टार्ट काउंटिंग. सो mathematicians, they use these counting numbers and they name them as natural numbers. So these counting numbers which begin from 1 followed by 2, 3, 4, 5 and so on are called natural numbers. What are they called? They are called natural numbers. So natural numbers, they start from 1. Let us now understand what are predecessors and successors. So consider any natural number. I have a natural number 50. Now 50 is a natural number, and when I add 1 to it, plus 1, 50 plus 1 is equal to 51. So for 50, the successor of 50 is 51. So for finding the successor, what do? We add 1 to the number. Similarly, if we have to find the predecessor of 50, we will subtract 1 from it. So 50 minus 1 equals to 49. So 49 is the predecessor of 50. So for finding predecessor of any number, we will have to subtract that number with 1. So predecessors, in previous class you might have learned or did exercise like this. For example, here I have 4 and then you have a blank space and you have to fill this space with the number that comes after 4. So what number comes after 4? For that we add 1 to 4, 4 plus 1 which is equal to 5. So 5 comes after 4, and I am telling you, when we add any number with 1, हमें क्या मिलता है? हमें उसका सक्सेसर मिलता है. तो सक्सेसर के लिए हम लोग ये भी कह सकते हैं, ऐसा नंबर जो आफ्टर, उसके बाद आता है. सक्सेसर अगर आफ्टर है तो प्रेडेसेसर क्या होगा? बिफोर. सो इफ़ वी वेयर टू फाइंड अ नंबर, फॉर एग्जांपल 8, इफ़ वी वेयर टू फाइंड द प्रेडेसेसर ऑफ 8, और लाइक इन अर्लियर क्लासेस यू हैव सीन क्वेश्चंस लाइक दिस, find the number that comes before. So here the number which comes before 8 is 7. Speaking of natural numbers, the number which comes before 8 is 7. So in this case, 7 is nothing but 8 minus 1. So for finding the predecessor, we will have to minus 1, and for finding the successor, we will have to add 1 to whichever number is given to us. Suppose I have number 2. If I have to find the predecessor and successor of 2, then I will simply subtract 1 from 2, then I will get 1, which is the predecessor of 2. And for finding the successor of 2, 2 plus 1, which is equal to 3. So successor is nothing but the number that comes after a given number, and predecessor jo hai wo aisa number hai jo before, which comes before a number. So here if I have to find a number which comes before 1, 1 ka agar mujhe predecessor find karna hai natural numbers mein, to अब 1 का प्रेडेसेसर फाइंड करने के लिए हम क्या करेंगे? इस स्पेस में हम कौन सा नंबर फिल करेंगे? फॉर फाइंडिंग द प्रेडेसेसर, आई विल हैव टू सब्ट्रैक्ट 1 फ्रॉम 1, एंड वी नो दैट 1 माइनस 1 इज 0. 1 माइनस 1 इज 0. बट कैन वी फाइंड 0 इन नेचुरल नंबर्स? नो, नेचुरल नंबर्स बिगिन विद 1. सो देयर हैज़ टू बी सम नंबर्स इन विच 0 is included. There has to be some collection of numbers जिसमें 0 included है. So ऐसे numbers को हम लोग whole numbers कहेंगे, which is the name of the chapter. So natural numbers begins with 1, then obviously whole numbers, they will begin with 0. So 0, 1, 2, 3 and so on. These are known as whole numbers. Whole numbers begin with 0. नेचुरल नंबर्स बिगिन विथ वन. सो यहाँ पे आप लोग देखोगे तो आपको पता चलेगा कि नेचुरल नंबर्स में अगर हम लोग ज़ीरो ऐड कर देंगे, यानी कि ज़ीरो स्टार्टिंग में हमें मिलेगा, सो ऐसे नंबर को हम क्या कहेंगे, दे आर होल नंबर्स. सो होल नंबर्स बिगिन फ्रॉम ज़ीरो एंड देन द रिमेनिंग नेचुरल नंबर्स. सो ज़ीरो विथ नेचुरल नंबर्स आर होल नंबर्स. नेक्स्ट लेट अस ट्राई दीज एग्जाम्पल्स. फर्स्ट राइट द प्रीडिसेसर एंड सक्सेसर ऑफ 19. फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल वी हैव टू फाइंड द प्रीडिसेसर एंड सक्सेसर ऑफ 19. सो एज आई टोल्ड यू बिफोर, फॉर फाइंडिंग द प्रीडिसेसर वी विल हैव टू सब्ट्रैक्ट वन फ्रॉम द नंबर. सो हियर वी हैव 19 and when we subtract 1 we get 18. So 18 is the predecessor of 19. And for finding successor we will have to add 1, because successor is the number that comes after. So the successor of 19 is 20. In the similar way you have to find both predecessor and successor, dono find karna hai of these numbers. So try these on your own. Second, is there any natural number that has no predecessor? Now, 1 is the natural number that has no predecessor, because when we subtract 1 from 1, we get the answer 0. And as I told you before, 0 is not a natural number. 0 is a whole number. Therefore, yes, there is a natural number that has no predecessor, and that number is 1. Question number 3. Is there any natural number which has no successor? Is there a last natural number? So the answer is, there is no natural number which has no successor. Every natural number has a successor, because we can keep on adding 1 to the given natural number and then we can find its successor. The greatest natural number does not exist, because natural numbers are infinite. There are many natural numbers. That means natural numbers does not have an end. So we cannot find the last natural number. So there is no last natural number. Let us try these examples. First, are all natural numbers also whole numbers? The answer is yes, all natural numbers are also whole numbers, and I have already explained it to you. Are all whole numbers also natural numbers? It is not necessary for all whole numbers, because 1 is a whole number and that is also a natural number. But 0 is a whole number which is not a natural number. 0 whole number to hai lekin wo natural number nahi hai, to ye ek exception hai. That is why all the whole numbers are not natural numbers. Third, which is the greatest whole number? Just like the case of natural numbers, as I have explained it to you before, every whole number has a successor. So the greatest whole number does not exist. We cannot find the greatest whole number, because there are infinitely many whole numbers. The next topic we are going to discuss is number line. So for drawing a number line for whole numbers, first of all draw a line, and in this line I have drawn a few division. So first of all you draw a line, and then in one point, take one point and label it 0. To the right of 0 take a fixed distance and label it 1. Label that point 1. So here to the right of 0 we have 1, and there is a distance between 0 and 1. So this distance is known as unit distance. Kya kehte hai is distance ko? Is distance ko hum kehte hai unit distance. So the distance between 0 and 1 is called unit distance. Now without changing this distance, for example aap log ye scale se draw kar rahe ho, aur yahan pe aap logo ne yahan 0 start kiya, aur this distance, this is 1 centimeter distance. And this distance I have told you is a unit distance. So when you are plotting 2 to the right of 1, वन के राइट में क्या प्लॉट करेंगे, वी विल प्लॉट टू, वी विल फाइंड अ पॉइंट एट यूनिट डिस्टेंस, सेम डिस्टेंस एंड लेबल इट टू. सो यहाँ पे इफ दिस इज 1 centimeter देन द डिस्टेंस बिटवीन 1 and 2 इट शुड ऑल्सो बी 1 centimeter. सिमिलरली द डिस्टेंस बिटवीन 2 and 3 शुड ऑल्सो बी 1 centimeter. सिमिलरली द डिस्टेंस बिटवीन 3 and 4 शुड ऑल्सो बी 1 centimeter. सो दिस फिक्स डिस्टेंस इज कॉल्ड unit distance. So if you are taking 2 centimeter, then all the distance should be 2 centimeters. So then only we can say that the distance is a unit distance. For here I have taken 1 centimeter, so this is unit distance between 0 and 1 and also between 1 and 2. Similarly here I have points that are at a unit distance, so here I can write 3 to the right of 2, to the right of 3, I can write 4, 4 ke right mein 5, then 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 and so on. So this is known as the number line for whole numbers. For whole numbers, this is the number line. This is how you draw a number line. मैं फिर से बताती हूँ, सबसे पहले एक लाइन ड्रॉ करना है और इस लाइन में एक पॉइंट मार्क करना है 0. स्केल एंड पेंसिल यूज़ करके ही आपको ड्राइंग करना है. वेन एवर यू आर ड्राइंग एनीथिंग यू शुड यूज़ स्केल एंड पेंसिल ओनली. सो हियर आई एम ड्राइंग अ रफ फिगर यूजिंग पेन सो दैट इट इज़ क्लियरली विजिबल टू यू. We will be starting with 0, we'll mark a point 0, then at unit distance we will have to mark a point 1 which is to the left, right of 0. 1 should be to the right of 0. To the right of 1 we will have 2. That means if we go in this direction we can find the successors. The successor of 1 is 2, the successor of 2 is 3 and so on. So this is how you draw a number line for whole numbers. Using this number line, we can find the distance between two points. For example, if I have to find the distance between the point labeled 4 and the point labeled 7. If I have to find the distance between these two, then it will be 1, 2, 3. 3 units. That means 4 plus 3, I will get 7. So here I am telling unit because I don't know exactly how much is the distance. So because it is a fixed distance, that is why it is called a unit distance. If I were to consider here 1 centimeter distance, then the distance between 1 and 3, it will be 2 centimeters. So this is how using the number line, we can find the distance between units. So here one thing we can observe is, as I told you, on the right side, the number will be greater. For example, to the right of 4, we have 5. So 5 is greater than 4. If we have a number like this 12, which is less than 15, 12 is less than 15, so 12 will come to the left of 15. When we draw on the number line like this, if here 15 is there, then here we will have 12, 13 and 14. So here to the left of 15 we will have 12. So if a number is smaller, agar number a given number se chota hai, to us number ke right left mein wo number hoga. Aur agar koi number a given number se bada hai, for example 5 is greater than 4, then we can say that 4 ke right mein 5 hoga. Aur hum log aise bhi keh sakte hai ki 5 ke left mein 4 hoga. Theek hai, in this case also hum log ye keh sakte hai ki 15 ke left mein 12 hai, lekin 12 ke right mein 15 hai. So this is how we can observe using the number line that the greater numbers are arranged to the right. For example, if we have 1000 and here I have 2000. So 1000 will be to the left of 2000 and 2000 will be to the right of 1000. ठीक है, so नंबर लाइंस को यूज़ करके हम लोग ये ऑब्जर्व कर सकते हैं कि जैसे ही हम राइट साइड में जाएंगे, हमें बड़े बड़े नंबर्स मिलते जाएंगे. अब कितने बड़े नंबर्स मिलेंगे? You are using numbers to count. So you can use these numbers, these whole numbers to count many things. If you have to count the number of students in your school, you can count these using whole numbers. If you have to count the number of people living in our country, living in India, then you can count that also. It will be a very, very big number, but we can count those numbers as well. If someone asks you to count the number of stars in the sky, if it was possible, then we will get a number, a very big number, very large number, but still hame koi na koi number milega agar जो स्काई में स्टार्स हैं उन्हें काउंट करना पॉसिबल होता तो. सो वी कैनॉट से विच इज़ द ग्रेटेस्ट होल नंबर, सबसे बड़ा होल नंबर फाइंड करना पॉसिबल नहीं है, बिकॉज द नंबर्स गोस ऑन इंक्रीजिंग एज वी गो फ्रॉम लेफ्ट टू राइट. इस डायरेक्शन में जाते जाएंगे तो यहाँ पे हमारे पास 1 crore के बाद 2 crore ऐसे नंबर्स आते जाएंगे. सो होल नंबर्स जो है उसमें ग्रेटेस्ट नंबर फाइंड करना पॉसिबल नहीं है, क्योंकि इसमें कितने सारे नंबर्स होते हैं, इनफाइनाइट नंबर्स होते हैं होल नंबर्स में. होल नंबर्स में इनफाइनाइट नंबर्स का मतलब क्या है, बहुत सारे या फिर अनगिनत. सो देर आर इनफाइनाइटली मैनी होल नंबर्स, दैट इज़ वाई वी कैनॉट फाइंड द ग्रेटेस्ट होल नंबर. सो दैट इज़ वॉट आई टोल्ड यू, वी कैन ऑब्जर्व दैट वेन वी गो फ्रॉम लेफ्ट टू राइट द नंबर्स कीप्स ऑन इंक्रीजिंग. द नेक्स्ट टॉपिक वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस इज एडिशन ऑन द नंबर लाइन. एडिशन ऑफ होल नंबर्स कैन बी शोन ऑन द नंबर लाइन. सो लेट अस सी द एडिशन ऑफ 3 and 4. सो हियर वी हैव टू एड 3 with 4. So 3 plus 4, we have to show the addition on the number line. For that we will start from 3 and we have to add 4 units to 3. So we will jump 4 times after 3. So here 1 2 3 4. So after the 4th jump we reach on the point labeled 7. So here from the number line, from addition, we can say that 3 plus 4 is equal to 7 when we show addition on the number line. Similarly, for 4 plus 5, if we have to show the addition of 4 with 5. So for that, we will begin with 4. Since we have to add 5 to this number, we make 5 jumps to the right. That is from 4 to 5, then 5 to 6, then 6 to 7, then 7 to 8 and 8 to 9. So when we start from 4, here I am drawing downwards because I have already drawn over here in the upward. So here we have first jump, second jump, third jump, fourth jump and fifth jump. So here the tip of the arrow, of the last arrow, is at the number 9. So here we can say that 4 plus 5 is equal to 9. So this is how we can show addition on the number line. You don't have to write these examples. I am writing in my notebook. In your notebook, ये सिर्फ आप लोग को समझाने के लिए मैंने लिखा है, ये आप लोग को लिखना नहीं है. Next, we have subtraction on the number line. Just like addition, we have subtraction on the number line. In addition, we went from left to right. So in subtraction, we will go from right to left. So first of all, let us consider an example of subtracting 4 from 7. 7 mein se hum 4 subtract karenge. So for that, we will begin with 7. And then, as I told you, we will go from right to left. So first, we have to make 4 jumps since we are subtracting 4. So when we go to the left, we will take first jump, second jump, third jump and fourth jump. Here also the tip of the arrow of the fourth jump's arrow is the answer. So here we have 7 minus 4 is equal to 3. Similarly, you can consider other examples. Just like we calculated 3 plus 4 which is equal to 7 on the number line, we can try these questions. You have to find 4 plus 5. So you will begin with 4 and then take 5 jumps and you will find the answer. So you have to try these questions and draw the number line in your notebook. Similarly, for subtraction as well, it is just as the example we solve. For 8 minus 3, you will start from 8 and you will take 3 points backwards, that means to the right. So whatever the number will be, you will have the number on the number line. So in this way, you can try these questions and solve them in your notebook. Next, we have multiplication on the number line. So here, let us start with multiplying 2 with 5. So using the number line, we are going to calculate 2 into 5. So here, since we have to multiply 2 with 5, we will take 5 units at a time. 5 units लेंगे at a time, so एक jump जो होगा वो 5 units का होगा, दूसरा jump जो होगा वो फिर से 5 units का होगा. ऐसे भी कर सकते हैं, या फिर अगर क्योंकि हमें पता है multiplication is commutative, so 2 into 5 और 5 into 2, we get the same answer as I have told you before. So here 5 into 2, so you have to take 2 units at a time, and how many times we have to jump? 5 times. 2 units at a time and jump 5 times. Aur answer same milega agar hum log 5 units at a time lenge and jump 2 times. So yahan pe ye iska representation dekh lete hain. We are taking 2 units at a time. So here we have the first jump, then the second jump, third jump, fourth jump and the fifth jump. So at the tip of the arrow we have the number 10. We have the point which is labeled 10. So here we can say that 5 into 2 is equal to 10. Similarly, if we consider this, 5 unit is the distance now. So first jump and the second jump, in here also we have the same answer. So we can say that it is equal to 2 into 5 as well. So this is how we multiply on the number line. In the same way, you can try these questions for multiplications. Here we have 2 multiplied by 6, and I have explained to you how you can find 2 multiplied by 5 on the number line. In the same way, you can find the solution for these answers using the number line. So you have to try these questions on your own and write these answers in your notebook.